In this video, we are going to see about projection of straight lines. When a particular line is inclined to both the reference plane, that is horizontal plane and vertical plane. So this is the example we are going to see. A line AB 80 mm long. So the length of the line is given as 80 mm. And the name of the line is AB. So one point is A and the other point is B. Has its end A 20 mm above HP. And 25 mm in front of VP, which means the point A is 20 mm above the horizontal plane, and the same point, that is A, is 25 mm in front of the vertical plane. The line is inclined at 45 degree to HP, so the HP inclination is given as 45 degree, and 35 degree to VP, that is VP inclination, vertical plane inclination is given as 35 degree. So draw its projections. So we are going to draw the projection of this particular line, that is AB. So first step is draw a horizontal line, that is axis line. So this is the horizontal line. Let us name this as XY. So this XY is the reference plane. Then it is given that the point A is 20 mm above HP. So from this reference line, mark 20 mm above. So mark a point A, that is 20 mm above this XY. So take a scale, so keep the scale anywhere over the XY line and mark a point, that is A, 20 mm. So I am marking here. So this is A dash, that is front view of that particular point. So let us name this as A dash. Then draw one locus line along this A dash point. So this line can be called as locus of A dash. So draw a vertical line from A dash to touch XY reference line. Then in the question it is given that the point A is 25 mm in front of VP, which means that is in front of VP can be clearly visible only in top view. So that A point can be marked below XY, that is 25 mm. So take a scale, measure 25 mm, put a point, this point can be called as A. So draw a horizontal line crossing through A, that can be locus of A. So then draw a vertical line from A up to XY. Then first let us draw the inclination of that particular line to HP. So the line is inclined 45 degree to HP. So let us draw only the front view. So the HP inclination will be visible only in front view. So front view will be visible above XY line. So let us draw first the HP inclination. So the true length of the line is given as 80 mm. So draw a line of 80 mm length for 45 degree angle. So take protractor from A, measure 45 degree. Then take the scale and draw a line of 80 mm length for 45 degree angle, that is HP angle. So this is the point we have kept for 45 degree inclination. So draw a line from A dash for 80 mm long. So this is 80 mm long. So this point can be called as B1 dash. So draw a horizontal line crossing through B1 dash. That will be the locus of B dash. So the B dash point which we are going to mark, that is the front view end point, will be B1. So that point will be exactly on this particular locus line, so that we can name this line as a locus of B dash. So draw a horizontal line crossing B1 dash. So this will be locus of B dash. So similarly, let us draw the VP inclination. So VP inclination is given as 35 degree. So always the VP inclination will be visible on top view. So the top view will be below XY line. So let us draw a line of 80 mm long that is inclined 35 degree to VP. So which means we can draw a line from A of inclination 35 degree, and the length of the line can be the true length of the line. Take the protractor, measure 35. So this will be 35. Mark one point and take a scale, draw a line for this particular angle, that is 35. The length can be of 80. So draw a line from A for 80 mm long. So this point will be called as B1. Draw a horizontal line crossing B1, which can be called as locus of B. Since the point B will get falls on this particular horizontal line, this can be called as locus of B. So we have drawn all the locus line. So the next step is, from B1 dash, draw a vertical line up to locus of A. So this vertical line should be parallel to A dash A line. So we have drawn a projection line from A dash to A. So this B1 dash line, so the vertical line from B1 dash, that should touch locus of A at one particular point. So let us name this as B2. So this vertical line should be exactly parallel to this A dash projection line. Similarly, draw a vertical line from B1 up to locus of A dash. So draw a vertical line from B1 upward up to locus of A dash. This can be marked as B2 dash. Then take a compass with A dash as center and of radius A dash B2 dash. Draw an arc towards locus of B dash line. So it will cut the locus of B dash line at one point. This point is called as the B dash point. So let us name this point as B dash. Similarly, take compass with A as center and of radius AB2. Draw an arc towards locus of B. So this arc cuts the locus of B at one particular point. This point is called as B, that is the ending point of top view. So take HP pencil, join A dash B dash to get front view. Similarly, join AB to get top view. Take HP pencil, join A dash B dash. So this is the front view. Similarly, join AB to get top view. So A dash B dash is the front view and AB is the top view. So that's all. We have drawn the projection when a line is inclined at an angle of 45 degree to HP and 35 degree to VP. So now the dimensions should be marked as per the question. So this A dash B1 dash is the true length of the line, that is 80 mm. So you can mark that as the true length. Similarly here, AB1 is the true length. So you can mark this as 80 mm. So the HP inclination we have drawn as 45 degree. So that should be marked here. Similarly, VP inclination given as 35 degree. So that should be marked here. Normally we will notate the HP inclination as theta and VP inclination is pi. So theta is 45 degree and pi is 35 degree. So next, at the side of the paper, we can write what is the true length, what is the front view length and what is the top view length and what is the front view angle and what is the top view angle. So front view angle will be noted as alpha and top view angle can be noted as beta. So at the side of the paper, write everything. So like this we can write what is the true length, what is front view length, what is top view length and what is front view angle and what is top view angle. So measure the length using scale and angle using protractor and write those values here. So as usual, here at the bottom of the paper you can write all dimensions are in mm. So that's all. Thank you. In next class we will see some more examples on projection of straight lines inclined to both the reference plane. Thank you.